Hi there, I'm Pauline, and in today's video, we'll be covering VS Code desktop support, which allows you to keep your local IDE configurations, including your keyboard shortcuts, and still benefit from Gitpod's high-spec servers and automated pre-builds. Please note that this feature is currently in preview. You can get started with VS Code desktop support in a few small steps. So first, start a new Gitpod workspace. In this case, I went from the repo and I've started a new workspace using our Google Chrome extension. So now you've got your workspace open, it's time to open the command palette. So we can just search here, open in VS Code, hit enter. And as you can see, I've got this pop-up that asks me if I wanted to open this workspace on the VS Code app. So we just click on open. This is now on my desktop, my VS Code app. And if I click on open, it is now, let's just continue. Yes. And as you can see, we're now running our Gitpod workspace in VS Code on the app. So what this means, like I said, all of your local IDE configurations, including your keyboard shortcuts, could be all used from here if you prefer it. But the added benefit is that you get to use Gitpod's high-spec servers and all the automated pre-builds and all the Gitpod features, which is pretty cool. So your code executes in an ephemeral Gitpod workspace, but you can still, if you're not used to developing on a browser, you can continue using VS Code as you usually would. And just to show you, so if you go on my gitpod.yaml file, you can see that my first terminal that I opened as part of this Gitpod YAML file is install Hugo dependencies, and you can see that's mapped it quite nicely on here, and it's also running, it ran all of these commands as part of the Gitpod automation. You may have noticed that in this Gitpod YAML file command, we're starting the Hugo server by using the Gitpod URL command, which binds the URL, the Gitpod URL for your preview, which is why you have a URL for it. But if you did want to use just your local host, then you can do that. And in this case, we could just do a Hugo server -d, and you can see that your application is running on port 1313, and you can open it in the browser. As you can see, it's mapped to localhost 1313 instead of the Gitpod URL. In this example specifically, it had the GP URL as part of the Gitpod automation. So just what I thought that was worth bearing in mind. What VS Code desktop supports is it installs and manages and runs the local companion app under the hood. So you don't have to do that. But if you do still want to use the local companion app, you can use it independently. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you learned something. If you have any more questions, please feel free to join our thriving community on Discord over at gitpod.io/chat, and we'll see you over there.